Welcome to the Be Ye Pumped podcast, where we will help you become focused on your goals with faith, covenants, and progress. And now your host, Malin Lewis. Get ready to be pumped up.
Yo, yo, yo. What is up, people? Guess what today is? It is Thankful Thursday, and I'm getting on this podcast just a little bit too late. I was up all night putting out my ebooks. If you haven't checked them out, go get them. They're only $4 for 24 hours right now for my birthday. I'm super pumped. It was some good, exciting stuff to get all that out to everyone, and hopefully they can be of some help in you guys and your life. It's just something I've been working on for some time now. And excuse me. So I am very, very grateful to be alive. I mean, you think about it. This is episode number 40 on my 40th birthday. Believe me, I did not plan it that way. I even knew I put out episode 39 yesterday, but I didn't think about it that today was my birthday. Excuse me. Boy, my voice. Anyways, you guys are amazing. You guys are awesome. Let me see if I can grab some water. Hang on. Oh, no water in here. So this is a real and raw episode, and I'm not kidding you, because I want to share some stuff with you guys. Number one, I am so extremely grateful to be alive. There's no doubt in my mind. You know what? I kind of feel like some music right now. I'm going to put some powerful, uplifting, and happy music on. Let's see what we get, huh? Oh, yeah. I kind of like that. I kind of like that music right there. Let's see. Make it rock. Let's see what that says, huh? I'm going to say, and we're going to pick the piano, because I kind of want a little bit deep. Here we go. Let's see what this offers. Okay, can you guys hear that? Not yet. Here we go. Let's see what we got today. But anyways, I'm 40 years old. Can you guys believe that? It's definitely a milestone. It's definitely a growth opportunity for me to recognize. So, oh yeah. I kind of like it. So I'm extremely grateful. I'm super pumped. I'm super excited about life. I mean, there's no doubt in my mind that we have an opportunity to grow at any point in our life. There is, I kind of don't like that music right now. Rise and shout. There we go. That's real pretty right there. There's a time in my life where we do get down, where we do struggle. I just got off done interviewing right now Kino Vega, good friend of mine, grew up Marine, husband, father. He's a grandfather now, and he does yoga, meditation. He's been dealing with chronic pain for so long. And when I asked him what he was motivated daily by, and his response was gratitude. It was immediate. He knew what he was motivated by, and he is grateful every day. Every day he doesn't know what the day will be like, if he's going to be in pain, if he's going to not be in pain. And wow, it just expressed, I guess not expressed, but it just showed me that we all live different lives. We all have different stories. We all have different circumstances that we come upon. And it's just so powerful and motivating to know that we all are in charge of our lives. You see, Kino took complete control of his life to be able to make the best out of his life. And I am super, super stoked for him. Going back to those ebooks that I put out, we talk about goal setting secrets, okay, a growth mindset, successful habits, and productivity success, all right? Those are the things that I put out. I want to talk about some things that you should avoid when setting goals. And I'm extremely grateful for goals, because it's what drives me. You see, goal setting is no different. Okay. You have your alert function on high when you start out goal setting. Everyone raise your hand, right? We all are so pumped up. We're so excited about that. It's going to get us on the right track and we're going to do everything. But the number one thing that we fail at doing that we should avoid is getting too excited about our goals. You see, in this state, avoid, you know, setting too many goals. It can allow us to be feeling overwhelmed and easily lose focus. Okay. Remember, we have other obligations in our life. You know, you got to stay energized and you got to stay focused to be able to take that at a time. So if there's other goals and other things that you want to accomplish, then set one or maybe two to get you there. Okay. Number two is make sure that your goals are setting that, like, they're your goals. They're not anybody else's, nobody else's that you saw on Instagram or Facebook or YouTube. Make sure that they are your goals. And it's okay to listen to other people's goals, but really make sure that that's what you want. Because if it isn't, then you're just not going to be able to do it. Okay. Number three is time has a way of slipping past you. You know, you really need to think on your goal completion time. Factor in all the things that may steal some of your time. You see, work harder with that schedule, right? Get it down on paper. That's the key, right? Get it down on paper. You want to avoid with the time slipping you by, okay? Number four is the so-called failure is a character builder. Yes, failure builds character, but it's how you react not to completing a goal that defines you. You see, understand that it is possible for you, you know, to complete that goal, or you may not even complete it. Okay. That's the time when you want to reflect and see what you can learn from that event. Ask yourself questions. Was it the right goal? Did I have the right time? Did I dedicate enough time? Ask yourself those type of questions, you know, like what roadblocks did I hit? Maybe even how can I avoid them next time, right? Then the number five thing to avoid is one way to avoid failure to complete a goal is to make sure that your goal is realistic for you. Okay. Yes, we're excited. We've got the big goal. I talk about making big goals, right? But one of the main reasons is that you need to make sure that you ask many questions before setting that goal. Okay. Make sure that it is realistic, right? Make sure that it is yours. Okay. Number six, narrowing your focus too much can honestly be a mistake. Okay. So an example would be you're getting a promotion to like assistant manager within the next 3 months. You identified what was lacking in the last assistant manager who was asked to leave the company. And now you are honed in doing everything necessary to stand out in the crowd, right? Of all the different candidates. You're putting in 14-hour days. You're doing all the things that are right. After 2 weeks of being a shining star, you start making mistakes. The issue about that is that you forgot about putting some of your focus into your health goals. Your health eating habit slips. After a hard 14-hour day, you accepted an invite to go for a nightcap with work friends, right? You're hanging out. You're going with them. And instead of just heading home and meditating before you go to sleep. Okay. Did you make your goals work for you? Were you able to be successful? Right? So think about those type of things, right? Was it more important for you to focus on you becoming an assistant manager and doing everything impossible? Or is it more important to go hang out with friends and those other things? Yes, it's still good to have friends. I agree. It's a good thing. But did you let your goal slip you by? Okay. Number seven is things that you should avoid. You need to review progress. And so if you don't do this, you will result in your goals not working for you. Make sure that you review it on a daily, weekly, hourly, monthly. I don't know how much more to stress it, but you need to review it often. Okay. However often means to you, that's what you need to do. Review your progress daily. It just makes sense. You have to be able to make adjustments so that way you stay on track. Okay. Those are those seven things that I think that would benefit for, you know, you guys in setting goals. What I want you to do now is to start setting goals. We only have like two more weeks left. Start setting goals now. Start building what you want in for 2020 and go get it. I don't know how much to express that. We need to be grateful for the time that we are living in. Okay. We need to be excited about everything that we're doing. We need to be excited. We need to be pumped up. There is passion in doing that. There is passion in following your dreams. There is passion in driving yourself to become successful. I don't know how much more to express that, but if you go and listen to the interview tomorrow about Keno, trust me this, you will come being grateful. You will come away being grateful and feeling like you're a better person. And then go do something about it. Take action. That's what we're big on, is the faith, covenants, and progress. See, faith leads to action, and action leads to making covenants with our Heavenly Father or promises. There is power in making covenants and making promises, right? It holds us accountable. It makes us want to do better. And then the blessings do come when you strive to do something better, right? And then you will see that incremental progress. You'll see that daily. It does come in daily doses. It may come in hourly. It may come in minute doses. But progress does come. You guys are amazing. Remember, stay motivated. Stay driven. Allow yourself to become fully focused and driven by what you need. Hey, I'm talking to you, that one person. Write down your goals. Make it a part of your life. Express gratitude on a daily basis. Write it down on a piece of paper. Write it down in a journal. Yes, do it. I'm serious. I know I'm kind of feel like I'm talking to myself, but go do it. You guys are amazing. Faith, covenants, and progress. Be ye pumped.